problem. Tell me what you want me to do. He said, what's in your house? When you serve the Lord and you got financial issues, don't ever forget, you have access to the right resources. Resources is where your stuff is going to come from. When you serve the Lord, you have the right. And you have access to the right resources. That is a promise that's given to you. You have access to the right resources. Some of you are in here tonight, you're going like, I don't really know why I'm in here. I just know. So you serve the Lord. So now you have access. You're in here. And faith cometh by what? That means you're getting ready to hear some things that are going to help you to get out of where you are. So there are always resources to solve problems. The issue is whether or not you're going to use the right resources or the wrong resources. There are right resources and there are wrong resources. A resource that will solve an immediate problem but leave you in a worse position in the long run, that's a wrong resource. Well, I know I can go over here and they'll give me the money and I can get this bill paid, but in the long run, you're going to end up paying that bill 9 more times. That's a wrong resource. We call that a payday cash loan. We call that borrowing money from crooked people. We call that getting money from people who are going to hunt you down every 5 minutes, take your kids, block your car in, put a bolt on your car. They look like they're beneficial. They look like they're right resources. But what are you having to do to get something from them in the long run? Are you worried about your life after you got something from them? Are you secure? Are they walking around now letting everybody know that you're broke, that you borrowed from them? You don't dig a bigger hole in the backyard and try to fill up the one in the front yard. A resource that will require that you go and steal, be disgraceful, that's a wrong resource. I tell you what I can do. I can get you out of this, but now you're going to have, that's a wrong resource. A resource that'll keep you under somebody's thumb in slavery. That's a wrong resource. A resource that's in conflict with God's word and you're now having to steal, beg, borrow. That's a wrong resource, y'all. I know nobody talks about our resources because you think, well, it's a break. It's a break. No, it's a wrong resource. A resource that's not equally yoked with your spirit. One that's not equally yoked with your faith. That's a wrong resource. No, but he's good and she's good, but they're not yoked with your spirit. That's a wrong resource. If you hide the resources and those that help you, if you can't tell folk you helping folk and you can't tell somebody who's helping you, that's the wrong resource. I don't want nobody to know. Why? Because you think that's the wrong resource. There are some resources that the people of God should not be using to solve their problems. There are enough resources that God has given us that we don't have to play on the devil's turf in order to survive. If you don't know the right resources, ask God. Go to him in prayer. And God will direct you where you ought to go. Stop trying to live off wrong resources. She went to Elisha because he had access to a good resource. You're in here tonight. I don't have some financial aid assistant coming down here to tell you we can give you a loan but just 2% to get you out of debt. No. We're going to get you out of debt without loaning or borrowing from anybody. Because what you have to get out of debt is already in your house. It's already in your possession.